Hi, I'm Remixto chef Brent Marsh. We're here for intheyucatan.com. Today it's an exciting day. We're in the Remixto house. This house has been under construction for nearly a year now, and we're kind of finally moved in. As you can see around us, we're still not fully constructed and we've still got a lot more to do, but you know, we're in and we're kind of living here, and it's an exciting time for us. So we've been creating a lot of food outside, a lot of barbecuing, a lot of grilling, and we want to share some of that with you today. We're going to be making arrachera tacos, which is like a flank steak taco, with a few little salsas and on some flour tortillas. Very simple, very easy, sort of no mess, no cleanup, and perfect when you're sort of camping out and, you know, living in the dust of construction. So in about 2 months, this space here is going to be transformed into our big kitchen. But in the meantime, we have to go upstairs to the bedrooms where we're sort of temporarily living until the space gets all cleaned up and ready to go. And this is it here, our temporary Remixto kitchen. It's kind of the same as what we've been doing up until now in past videos, but we're now just in a new location. So these tacos are really easy, good for like a little barbecue, a little late night dinner, that kind of thing. Just really simple, quick to put together. And it all centers around this, arrachera. This is like quintessential Mexican steak. It's like flank steak. In the States you would call it flank steak. And it's just a really lovely cut of beef, just because it fries up so well for tacos. It's a little tough, but when you slice it up for tacos at the end, like all that little chopping, makes it nice and tender. It's full of flavor and nice and juicy, and just really perfect for grilling and putting on tacos. So we're gonna put that straight on the barbecue here. Now, what I've done is I've marinated this arrachera in just a bit of orange juice, some garlic, and a bit of black pepper. And that's it, maybe a little salt, and that's all I've done. And that's been marinating for about like 12 hours. And besides the steak, we're also going to put on the accompaniments. Today we're going to be making arrachera tacos with poblano chilies. These are the poblano chilies here. And we're just going to throw that straight onto the barbecue there. And we're going to grill it like a red bell pepper, where you grill it and then peel off all the blackened skin. That's exactly how you use these chilies, and they're fantastic. In addition, we'll throw on a few tomatoes, maybe a little jalapeno there. And then finally, a bit of onion. And we're just gonna let all that grill together. These ingredients here are gonna be turned into a salsa. This is gonna be chopped up here and just sort of put on our tacos. And then obviously the arrachera is gonna be chopped up very finely. And the whole thing's gonna come together in this wonderful, great taco. Okay, so our meat's starting to look a little cooked. We've flipped both sides now, and these smaller pieces are looking well done. Actually not well done, they're probably sort of medium rare, and that's kind of where we want them for the tacos. They'll be a little red in the middle, a little pink in the middle, but we won't get any juice sort of flowing from them when we chop it, so that's really ideal. Our vegetables are starting to get a nice little black. Tomatoes are taking on a little colour and getting cooked there, they're looking really nice. And our poblano, nice little blackening on the skin there. And so we'll keep going for that a few minutes longer. Okay, everything's pretty much done. Our vegetables are all there, and we're ready to go on to the next step. Okay, molcajete. In Mexico, this is how we make salsa. We basically take all our ingredients here, our tomatoes, our onion, and our jalapeno, and we drop them in the molcajete. We'll just chop that off and maybe give those a little chop up to make our job easier. And then we start pounding. And you can see that everything's so very nice and juicy and soft, and this won't take us long at all. A few minutes later, and we're pretty much done. Delicious salsa. All we need now is to add a little salt. For our poblano, we're just gonna let it cool a bit, and then we're just gonna start peeling off the skin like this. It's actually still really hot and sort of burning my hands a little bit. So a nice little trick is to take a dishcloth and just sort of wipe it with a dishcloth here. And it just protects your hands, and all that skin just sort of wipes off like that. We don't want to wash it because it's going to get rid of all those nice sort of charcoal-y flavors. So we're just trying to pull off the skin. And we don't have to be too particular, a little skin left on is fine. And that's about it, we're ready to chop that. Okay, now this is gonna add a little bit of heat to our tacos, so we don't have to be too particular about getting rid of the seeds here. We'll just leave a few in and that'll give it a nice heat. And we'll just chop that up like that. The joy of being cooking outside is you can let a few things fly and it'll just disappear into the garden. And that's that. And finally, we need something creamy. Every good taco needs something a little creamy. Today, that's gonna come in the form of an avocado. This here is a local avocado that's indigenous to the Yucatan. Actually, I don't know if it's indigenous to the Yucatan, but it's certainly grown here and they grow really well through the summer. It's not as creamy and sort of luscious as a Hass avocado, it's kind of thin, but it's also kind of sweet and has a slightly different flavor, which is just really lovely on the tacos we're making today. You can see also that it's absolutely ginormous. So one of them feeds like a family of 10 million. And so we're not actually gonna even use all of it. We'll just peel off the skin there and we're gonna pop it straight in the blender. There it goes. So we're gonna be making a kind of guacamole, but normally in a guacamole we would add tomatoes, we'd add onions, maybe a little chili, something like that. But we've already made all those flavors in our salsa, so we don't wanna repeat ourselves. Really the only things we're missing here are avocado and some cilantro here. And so our salsa, our guacamole today is just gonna be those two ingredients. So we're gonna get some really nice clean flavors that are gonna really marry well with our tomato salsa. So just a handful of cilantro, maybe a little water so that it can turn nicely, and a hint of salt, and that's it. And there we are. A delicious, creamy topping for our tacos. And so here we are, everything's ready. Let's chop the meat and eat some tacos. So we want to chop this up pretty finely. Notice I'm chopping against the grain, across the grain like that, and that's going to lead the whole thing to be a little softer here. And then we'll go the other way. And then finally, just give it a rough chop like that. At this point, maybe a little salt. On a comal here, I'm just heating up some flour tortillas. These are homemade, but store-bought are totally fine. They're nice and warm now, so under the napkin they go. And we'll take one there. A little deliciously barbecued beef. A little guacamole. A little tomato. A little poblano there. And there we are. Arrachero tacos with poblano peppers, a little salsa, and some avocado sauce. So all that's left now to do is enjoy. So I'm Remixer Chef Brent Marsh, here in the Yucatan.com. Check us both out online, and I hope you try these at home. Happy eating.